Hello, and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan. And today we're going to be diving into the world of organic chemistry. Specifically, we're going to be looking at how to name alkanes with branches. Now, this is part of my introductory organic chemistry series, so let's really go into how we can start naming these. So prior, we've learned all about how to name alkanes and that there is a very systematic way to doing these. Now, with branches, which are commonly known as substituents, are parts that are breaking off the main chain and can be a little bit tricky when it comes to naming them. The good thing is we're doing this systematically, so it all comes down to how many carbons are there within a given chain, right? So most of your different branches are generally very small. Typically, they don't go above 5 carbons, but it is possible for you to even get larger than this. So now when it comes to most of these, right, if you think of a one carbon alkane, you think methane, right? Especially when you think of that alkane. So whenever we're looking at these, so the very first species, is it you're just taking the prefix of it, which is that meth part of it, and then you're going to be adding the suffix of it, which is the YL ending. Now, being that these are alkyl chains, right, we will always be using that YL ending to denote that, hey, we have a branch, or as I mentioned before, a substituent. So both names can be used in this case. So methyl is for one carbon, and we can continue to name the rest of them. So 2 is going off eth, right? Think of like ethane, ethanol, all those different species. We're going to keep that beginning prefix and then put the YL ending on it as well. So I'm going to put these YLs here. So we have ethyl, then we have 3 carbons, which is propyl. Then we have 4 carbons, which is butyl. And then we have 5 carbons, which is pentyl. So it's taking that beginning part of that name, right? And this is something that if you're taking organic chemistry, you need to memorize these different endings. They're going to be a huge part when it comes to naming structures, drawing structures, and really diving into all these. So let's go through this and do a how-to guide of exactly how to name them. So first things first, when you are naming these, you have to identify and name what the longest carbon chain is. So you have to be comfortable with knowing your carbons from generally from 1 to 10 when you're doing these. Now, when I refer to the parent chain or the longest carbon chain, this has to be continuous carbons connected together. So it has to be in one solid line when you're going through it. The second step is we're going to be identifying all branches. There's a number of ways that you can try to do this. You can circle them, you can underline them, you put arrows on them, star them, but you need to be able to identify your branches. Then you need to number your carbons, so on your parent chain, and you want to start on the end that is closest to a branch. And we're going to go through examples to show this. Then you want to give the location and name each branch in alphabetical order when we do this. Sometimes you might have identical branches as well, and we'll have to fold in some special prefixes as well. Let's take a look at our first examples and use these steps to help us. All right, let's start with the first carbon chain here. So what we're going to be doing first is naming and identifying what our longest carbon chain is. So one thing that I like to do is if you're really new at this, is I try to figure out and start at all of the different ends that are possible. And what you are essentially doing in this case is you're trying to see is like what kind of different angles can you go to try to connect these, right? So if I go across, I can see that I have 4 different carbons here, right? So you got 1, you have 2, 3, 4. So that's one possibility. I could wrap around and go up, and we notice that, okay, this one's only 3 total carbons. So that's a little bit shorter. We could also go from maybe the left-hand side and go up, and we see that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there's different options that are available, and they'll all give you the same answer as long as you pick the longest chain. So let's go from the one that I have here going across. That's always the easiest thing to do. We have 4 carbons in this particular one. So 4 carbons, that we're going to put that name down, and that will be butane, right? Butane is 4 carbons. We have the ane ending to say that's an alkane, bute meaning 4. Now, the next step is trying to identify all of the different parts that are outside your parent chain. So one thing I personally like to do is I always maybe circle my parent chain. So that way I can remember where exactly is it, especially if you have a tendency to forget or get lost while you're doing it, it can serve as a reminder. So that means there's one carbon that is outside of it, right? So this one here in green is outside of that group. So this is going to be our substituent or our branch. And now when we are numbering that parent chain, we have to start at the end that's closest to it. So if you look up here, right, what's closest? Well, if I do it on the right, I can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4 if I start from the right-hand side. Now, we always want to give the lowest number possible, so that's why we start at the end that is closest to our branch. So now, what is the name of that branch? Well, if you remember from before, you have one carbon. One carbon was methyl. So what we will do is we will number its location, and then we will name it. So it'll be 2-methylbutane will be the first name. And that's how you would go about that. Let's try another one. Let's keep trying to work on these. So I have another example over here in the corner. So how exactly would you do this? Same idea as before. You're trying to figure out what is the longest possible chain as you're going through all these different angles. So you're going to be, so the first thing is most people will do is they'll count across, right? So if you do that, you can see we have 5 carbons that are here. That might be your longest. What other options could there be? We could do 1, 2, 3, 4. That's not longer. We could do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the same length. So that should be the same molecule. So when it comes to naming, so it looks like 5 is your longest. So 5, this is one of the ones that goes off your geometric shapes. So that would be pent for 5. And being that we are talking about an alkane, it will have that A-N-E ending for pentane. All right, now what about numbering and naming them? Well, when it comes to trying to actually look at this parent chain here, we want to make sure that we are numbering for whatever part is closest to a branch. So I just outlined it in orange for us. And you can see that the branch that's on the right-hand side is a little bit closer. Keep in mind, you don't always have to start from the right hand. It just happens to be that I picked one that was on this side. So we would start numbering over here. So it'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. All right, so we have 2 of them, right? And the thing is about this is, there was a little bit of a rule with this. So let's take a look at that real quick. Is that when you have 2 of them and they're identical, we have to use these little prefixes that are here. So we had 2 methyl groups. Each one had 1 carbon each. So being that they are identical, we are going to use the di prefix to say where this is. So let's take a look at what this would look like and how we would go about doing this. Let's go back to the problem. 3, 2, 1, go. So this is one area that you want to make sure that you do use that prefix. So being that you have 2 of them, one's at 2, the other one is at 3. We will put a comma to say where each one is located. Even if they're on the same carbon, you've got to include the number for every single one. Every branch has to have a number. Now, being that they are both methyl, we are going to use the di prefix, and then we will say methyl. So it'd be 2,3-dimethyl. Pentane would be the complete name for this structure. So we break it down one at a time. The 2,3 tells you the location of it. Where's it at? Di tells you that there's 2 of them and that they're identical. And that methyl is at, and methyl is how many carbons there are for those branches. And pentane was the length of the chain. Let's try another. So if I have this one, once again, we got to try to figure out what's our longest chain. And there might be multiple options. It doesn't always have to go across. So one thing is, if I were to look at this, right, if I go across, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, great. Let's try a different way. If I do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that also works. So this is one thing that you got to keep in mind when you start doing isomers, that you have to count every time, you know, name them. That's the best way to try to figure them out. So we see we have 6 is most likely the longest. So let's go through and do 6. 6 is a hexagons, right? So hexane would be the name here for the parent. So hexane is our longest. And how about for fun, we'll number it along the weird route here where it wrapped around the ring. It doesn't have to go along the zigzag necessarily. it just kind of makes it a little bit different. So when we're numbering this, we want to try, our goal is to always give more substituents a lower number. Now, when you look at this, you see that, oh, well, I have two methyls that are both three, and I also have an ethyl that is three as well. So which one should you pick when you're going through this? That's a little bit harder. So the thing is, when you're numbering these, you always want to give more a lower number. Now, why am I saying that? Is because if I start numbering from the right, I can give two methyls a three. Versus, let's say if I go on the other side, notice how I can give another branch a three as well. Well, they both would have a really low number, so it's closest on both sides. But you want to try to serve the common good. Which one can serve more substituents, more branches? So being that you have two branches, you have one here, that can be two that you are helping. All right, we also have a branch that's up here as well. So we have another one that is here. So why don't we maybe circle each one just to kind of help us guide our eyes for later. So we got one, two, and then three. Let's go through and name them. So we know we have hexane. Now, what would come first in that name? Well, being that we have multiple types, we alphabetize them in order. So being that I have a two-carbon branch, this is what we refer to as an ethyl. So we will label that, right? So we have ethyl, and then we have our dimethyl on the side, just like we did kind of on the last prompt, but they're both on the same carbon this time. So ethyl would be first. So what we would end up doing is, being that's on number four, we will say 4-ethyl, and then we have two methyls on the same spot. So that's going to end up being 3-3. So being that they're both on three, dimethyl hexane. And that would be the complete name for the structure. So you're systematically going through each of these structures. Let's try another example. So if I were to go through this one, well, how exactly, where should I start in numbering it? There's all kinds of different pathways you can realistically choose here. So one thing is, well, you know, I want to try to be close to branches. So if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's pretty long. If I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, that one's longer. Can I do anything else? Let's see if I go over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It looks like 8 is our longest route. So what we're going to do is we're going to outline that pathway. So that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Sorry. Sometimes counting is hard. All right. So we're going to number those. Now we want to give everything the lowest number possible. So we start from the right again. We will happen to be closer to our one of our branches. And that's another thing to keep in mind when you are trying to number all these different alkanes. You generally always want to make sure that you're including all branches. Try to make them as simple as possible for yourself when you're doing this. All right, so if we were to look here at the first one, we have 1, 2 methyls. And then we have another two carbon species, which once again is another ethyl. So how would we go about numbering this? First thing is name your parent chain. What was 8? Which is octane, right? Octane as in what you drive for your car. So we'll put octane, then in alphabetical, what comes first, ethyl or methyl? Well, E before M. So what we will do is we will number that. We have 5, ethyl. And then we will put 3, 4 dimethyl for our other branches. And that is our entire name. So it would be 5-ethyl, 3-4 dimethyl, octane would be the entire name for the species. So when you're going through these, just remember, find your longest carbon chain, try to count from every end, name it, right? If you need to, put them on flashcards. Then afterwards, you're going to identify and number the branches. And then you're going to, when you're writing it out, you write out your parent name and then put the location and the name of each branch, put them in alphabetical order. And don't forget about the prefixes, right? If it's di, tri, and tetra, it just keeps taking practice. So keep trying and you will get better. Thank you so much for listening. I hope that this video helped. And if it's your first time here, if you haven't been here before, comment below if you want to tell me all about or have questions, or hit that like and subscribe button to the channel. I really appreciate it. Thank you all so much, and I'll see you all later. Bye now.